Well, today we will talk about the differences between English and Chinese. And before we do, I want to discuss the homework we had last week. Please provide at least 3 English rules that you memorized and expected to know why. Expected to know why, okay? 请你改一下文法。Expected, 等一下 later, okay? This is just a reminder for me so that I know what are the rules I need to cover in my class and what are the previous questions you had, okay? So it's for my design of instructions. The second one is to prepare you for the content we are going to talk about today. One of the characteristics English has is aboutsentence structure. Which one is preferred in English and why? In Chinese, we say, 未避免伤亡请系紧安全带 That's quite normal, right? That's the predominant way of saying this. 未避免伤亡请系紧安全带 How do you translate this into English? I give you 2 choices. Which one is preferred?Remember, I said preferred, not which one is correct, okay? Which one is preferred? Both are meaningful, both are grammatical, both are acceptable, right? But one is preferred. A, to avoid death or injury, please fasten your seatbelt. B, please fasten your seatbelt to avoid death or injury. Which one do you think English prefers?Let's have a vote. Sentence A, please raise your hand. Okay, very good. Sentence B, apparently the majority chose B. Why? Yes?
I think simplicity is the beauty.
Simplicity? You think second one is simpler? Why?
Because you just have one sentence and the first one has 2 sentences.
Without a comma. The first one is a sentence too, but there's a comma, right? Comma, okay? So you think the second one is simpler. Interesting point. Any other answers? Any other reasons? Yes, please.
It's not please.
Okay?
It's not an order, or they're not telling you fasten your seatbelt because otherwise this is going to happen.
Okay?
It's more like a suggestion. You could fasten your seatbelt in order to whatever.
Okay, but the first one has please too, although in a later part, afterwards. So you prefer please at the beginning. Okay, that's our second reason. What else? Yes, please. Very good. Did you hear that? What did she say?
The verb is at first.
The verb?No, not the verb. Say it loudly.
in English, the main point, the things you want to say is put in front of the first part of the sentence.
Okay, it's not the verb. It's the main point. It's the main point. I hate this microphone. Is it okay? Is it bearable? No.That's exactly the point. You will see in our following discussion that English has a certain way of packaging the information. Here, we have 2 things to talk about. One is purpose, right? So, in order to avoid death or injury, okay, you have to do this, right? There are 2 clauses, 2 points, 2 things to talk about. Which one is the main point?In terms of meaning, don't worry about structure yet. In terms of semantics, okay? What is the main point? Fasten your seatbelt. That's what I really want to say. I just want to say, hey, fasten your seatbelt, right? And then I give you a reason to motivate you to do it, to avoid death or injury. This is the preferred way of arranging your meaning. You always put the main point first. You communicate the main point first. And that's one of the unique characters of English. I call it 重点在前。有没有人记得？重点在前。Okay, now we'll get to... So last time we talked about every language has a grammar, okay? And the grammar fulfills the purpose of communication, the job of communication, by having certain coding devices. Remember? 标记系统, coding devices. And by 标记系统 or marking devices, by marking devices or coding devices, we simply mean there's a sign, okay? A visual or an oral sign, 符号, right? Which carries a specific meaning. 还记不记得上次我们讲到 form and function 之间的配搭? Remember this one? Okay, so always have this picture in your mind. We have form, like what you see. Please fasten your seatbelt to avoid. This is a form, and it has a special function to convey the meaning. And the mapping between form and function is different among languages. Okay? So, every language has its own characters, personalities. Just like 不同的人有不同的个性, just like different people have different personalities. Same for language. And 语法形式, the way we express things, reflects this unique character, this unique personality. And what's difficult for us,Chinese native speakers to learn English. What makes it difficult is the way we have in Chinese to express things, the way Chinese maps form and meaning. So just get back to this. In Chinese, this is the way we say it. This is the form we use. Although the meaningIt's the same, right? We want to get you to fasten your seatbelt because of this. But the way Chinese says it, we put the purpose first and then the main point last. This is unique, right? About Chinese. In English, it's different. So this is one of the difficulties we have.由于形意搭配的 ，OK, mapping of form and meaning 的原则是根深蒂固。学习新语言的障碍就常来自于母语的影响。So every mistake Chinese students commonly made was from the influence of Chinese. OK, now for us to really grasp.The whole character of English, we need to know what are the differences between the two languages. 中英文有何不同的形意搭配关系? Let's look at an example. Here is the meaning, right? Functions, I mean communicative functions. Remember, I always remind you, whenever I talk about function, this word means what? Hello, gentlemen.When I talk about function, what do I mean? What kind of function I'm talking about? Hey, 请两位 gentlemen 回答。Were you here last time?
Yeah.
Okay, then I must have talked about this. 当我说功能功能的时候, what do I mean by 功能?Huh? can be many, many different things, right? 你的体能，你的食物的功能，教学的功能 ，right? 你实验的功能。So what am I talking about here? When I say functions, I mean what? Communicative functions. Always remember this. Okay, so these are the communicative functions I want to convey, right? I want to talk about existence, and I want to talk about ownership. What do you, existence? 懂吗？存在。所以什么叫存在？ There are four people in the house. There are 54 students in this class. This is 存在。You all exist here. Okay? You occupy the space here. Right? 什么是拥有？I have a house. Okay? So these are two different meanings. But in Chinese, we choose to use the same form for these two different concepts. 我们说拥有，我有一个房子。这里有54位学生。We use the verb 有, right?For both existence and ownership. Why? Well, later I'll show you, because these two concepts are mutually related. Okay? But in English, you have two different forms to convey the two different meanings. When you want to say ownership, you say have, right? I have a car, I have a wife, I have two kids. Okay?But existence, there is. 明天有一场比赛。You don't say, I have a ball game, right? You say, there is, there will be a ball game. Okay? So there is, there are. Meaning, 存在。So, the problem we have. Have you been tutoring anyone? 你们有没有做过英文家教？国中的考题里面常常喜欢考这个，房子里有四个人，有没有考过这个？房子里有四个人 ，OK， 我家的房子里有四个人 ，So my house has four people，OK，、okay? 有没有听过这种中式英文？The reason because in Chinese we do use the same form for two different meanings， 所以怎么学英文？搞清楚英文的 form。And function 之间的配搭关系，中英文配搭关系不同。Next one. A lot of people ask me, what's the difference between two and four? When do you use two? When do you use four? Have you had that question? 你们有没有这个问题？ Yes? No? 中文说卖给你的这本书卖给你， right? 这本书卖给你，然后这本书呢？买给你 ，OK， 都用给。可是，请问卖给跟买给意思一不一样？什么叫卖给你？卖给你，卖给你，你是一个什么 recipient？ 你是一个 receiver， 所以是你是一个 goal 卖给你 ，OK。可是，什么叫买给你？哎，这本书是为你买的。是买给你的，你是一个什么受益者 ？OK， 搞清楚了吗 ？OK， I sold this book to you。可能你并不是真的这个人，你是不是要买书的人啊？我只是把书卖给你，然后你呢要拿去给别的人，你不见得是真正的受益者 ，but you are the receiver。OK， 这本书买给你，你是我买书真正的受益者。是一个 beneficiary 的概念 ，so this book is bought 什么？英文说什么？看到没有 ？For you， 为什么是 for you？ 我为你买的，我买给你来用，你是受益者。但是这本书卖给你的“给”呢，是 to 的意思。This book is sold to you。OK， 你是接收。Recipient, receiver, goal. 那这就是 to 和 for 的不同。Whenever you use to, 永远是目标， 方向、目的。OK， 永远都是这个意思 ，to 的意思。回到形意标记的原则啊 ，whenever you see to， 这是一个 form， right？ To 就是 to 的 meaning。我以后会常常讲这句话哈 ，to 就是表达 to 的 meaning， for 就是表达 for 的 meaning。那 for 的所有的，你会觉得很多词有很多意思，可是他们其实都是从一个核心语义开始 ，they all develop from a core meaning。So the core meaning of for is always beneficiary. The core meaning of to is always goal. This goal can be spatial, 可以是空间上的 goal. So I went to your house, 看到没？是不是空间上面的目标？了解吗？ This to can be temporal goal, 可以是时间上的。OK? 刚刚说的 fasten your seatbelt to...Avoid, okay. I plan to do something. 是不是时间上面的 future goal? You see what I mean? Okay, 可以是 purpose the goal in order to purpose the goal. 可以是时间上的 goal. I plan to go to 日月潭。可以是空间上的 goal. Okay, 这样了解吗？ But it's always goal.那怎么分？搞清楚英文形意标记的原则。OK， 好，这个部分只是一个小小的 illustration。我们刚刚看到的基本上是词汇。We see the mapping of words, right? Words to, for, have, there is, into their meanings.那词汇的标记尚且如此，更何况语法？语法是句子的结构。我们来看一看句子的结构上面有什么问题。其实教英文啊，真的应该从中文开始，因为如果你不了解你的中文习惯，你就不知道怎么去检视、反省你的英文写作或说法。看看我讲的有没有道理哦。我是老师哈，所以我问你们，来，我很喜欢这个帅哥哦，他的这个语言学训练很好，所以呢，请他当道具一下 ，OK？ 注意哦，我今天从来没跟他讲过话，对不对？今天我是第一次跟他讲话，所以我就看着这位帅哥，哎，几点到的？回答、啊，
1:30。1:30，
到了以后做什么？
考试。
考试，考得怎么样？
不怎么样，
不怎么样。回忆一下我们刚刚在做什么哈？几点到的？到了以后做什么？考试，考试考得怎么样？我很欣赏这位同学，因为他一直坐在中间最前面啊，表示是最认真的，所以也麻烦你来当一下。哎，吃饭没？
吃了。
吃了，吃什么？
面包。
好吃吗？We had a fluent communication, right? We had a successful communication, a meaningful dialogue between two people in Chinese. Have you noticed any significant characters of Chinese? 几点到的？我在问谁？谁几点到的？Did I say it? 到了以后做什么？谁到了以后做什么？考试，然后马上我说考得好不好 ？Right? 谁考？有没有发现我都可以不说 ？But he understood. Right? 同样的，再换一个同学，吃饭没？他怎么知道我在跟谁讲话？他怎么知道我在讲哪一餐？吃饭没？吃了。吃什么？面包。And pay attention, I changed my topic already. I ask, 好吃吗？什么东西好吃？ What is good to eat? 什么东西好吃？面包。But did I say it? 我有没有说面包好吃吗？ Yeah, I can say it. I can say 面包好吃吗？ But I didn't, right? And she understood. It's understandable. Even though I drop all the subjects, did you notice that? 有没有注意到？嘿，有没有啦？这不是很简单的事情吗？ I ask a question, you answer. Okay? Have you noticed this before? Before today's class, did you notice this? 今天以前你有没有注意到？你讲话常常是没有主词的。Why? Why can we do this?Because 中文重情境，英文严句子。什么意思？中文是一个情境导向的语言。什么叫情境导向？就是 discourse centered, discourse oriented. OK? 我整个的语法结构是把周边的环境、人物、时间、主题 everything in the contextEverything in the discourse 纳入考量的 OK 不要小看这件事情 The reason why I can drop my subject because it's clear in the discourse If I look at this gentleman OK 几点到的 Who is the most possible addressee?Do you get my point? The discourse in that particular moment made everything clear. Do you agree? Okay? So, 情境导向的意思就是将说话时的情境场景纳入考量。我拿着一本书问你 Okay? 看了没？还没有啊，好大胆啊！第三周了还不看书 ，OK？ 了解吗？看了没 ？Hey, not only I drop the subject, I also drop what? 看了 what? I also drop what? Object. Yes. 看了没 ？The only thing I said is the verb. OK, and tense. 看了没 ？Have you read?This is exactly what I say in Chinese. Have you read? You see my point? I drop both the subject and object because 我拿着一本书问你 This discourse context made the participants obvious. Okay? 这叫情境导向 But what about English? 英文言句子因为它是语句导向的语言。什么叫语句导向？就是每一句话你都得给我说清楚。You have to make your point clear in every sentence. And every sentence has to have a clear subject, verb, object. 所以把这个句子翻译成英文。即使同样的场景，我拿着一本书问这位帅哥Exactly the same discourse context, right? 了解吗? But what do I have to say in English? Have you, okay, read the book? Or have you read it, right? At least I have to have some kind of a marker there. I have to make it marked in my sentence. Do you see my point?Nothing can be left out. Nothing can be omitted. Have you read the book? An answer? In Chinese, you can just say, 看了, right? Again, leaving out the subject and the object. But in English, what's the answer? Have you read the book?
A little bit.
Have you read the book? My
yes,
question.
I have.
Yes, I have.Okay? Yes, I have. Or, yes, I have read it. Okay?
Professor, what if you have an imperative sentence?
Good. That's a different purpose. That's a different sentence structure. For imperative, my command is toward the addressee. Clear. The subject is always you. By dropping you, so stand up. I'm actually saying you stand up. But you is clear in every language. So that's a very good question. Imperative is a cross-linguistic speech act. Okay? It's not a basic sentence structure. It's a special form for a special purpose. And cross-linguistically, you drop you because the subject is you. Okay? It's understandable in every language. You see my point? Okay. Now, we are talking about the basics. The basics, okay? The fundamental structure. Okay. Now, because Chinese is discourse-oriented, what's most important in our sentence structure is a topic. Why? Look at these examples. In Chinese, I say, 他的家很大, okay? 很漂亮, 我们常去. This is a typical Chinese sentence. 他的家很大, 很漂亮, 我们常去. 去哪里? 去哪里? 去他的家. 为什么他的家可以省略? Why I can leave out 他的家? Because I already established a topic. So because Chinese is discourse-oriented, in a sentence, the most important element is the topic, not the subject. It's the topic. What is a topic? This is a topic. A topic, once established, can be carried on in the other clauses, sharing the same topic. So Chinese sentence structure is like this. 他的家, once the topic is established, you can comment on the topic with other short sentences or clauses. Okay? What is the subject then? Look at this. 他的家, my topic for this utterance, right? 房子很大, 院子很漂亮, 浴室还有自然采光. Is this a typical Chinese sentence? No? No? Do you think this is a normal Chinese sentence? Sure do. 他刚搬了新家, 房子很大, 院子很漂亮, 浴室还有自然采光, 可不可以? Okay, 他那个新家啊, 他那个新家啊, 房子很大, 院子很漂亮, 浴室还有自然采光. Right? Typical Chinese sentence. Why do we have these kind of... And then look. If you want to translate all this one sentence, this is a period in Chinese, right? If you want to translate this whole sentence into English, how many sentences you will have? Do you see what I mean? This will be a sentence. The house is big. The yard is pretty. The bathroom has natural lighting. Do you see my point? But why I only use comma in this one sentence? So the consequence of discourse-oriented approach to coding is you have a sentence, a long sentence, with one topic. And under the same topic, you can have different subjects. Do you get my point? Under the same topic, you can comment on different aspects of the topic. And these things serve as subjects of that clause. So, 他的家房子很大, 房子是这个小句的主词, 院子是这个小句的主词, 浴室是这个小句的主词, But all these clauses were put under one period because they share the same topic. 所以在英文里面，中文重情境主词 ，I'm sorry， 主题为大，主题为大。请这边加上一句哈，主题为大，意思就是主题是必要的元素。什么叫必要的元素？一个句子里面必要的元素。不信的话，回去看看报纸的文章。所以今天的其中一个作业就是请你回去找一篇文章 ，OK， 报纸也好，你最喜欢的读本也好，来看看中文是不是这样的句子。OK， 以主题环绕主题的。如果你不信的话，我们再往下看。这是一篇我从一本书里面截录的，这本书叫做恋恋风尘 ，OK， 讲的呢就是新竹的文物古迹。那新竹最有名的是新竹的玻璃工艺博物馆。So， 大家一起来念一下，好吧？Can you count how many clauses you have in this one sentence? This is one sentence. There's only one period. 请问这句话里面有几个小句？有几个逗点？ 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 所以有八句话， right? And it's one period. 为什么可以有这么长的一句话？中文的句号代表的是主题的单位，因为 all these clauses were centered around the same topic. Topic 是什么？竹堑玻璃工艺博物馆。然后从此之后，你来看看它的句子啊。建于西元，什么东西建于？啊？为日治时期自治会馆，什么东西为？意为什么东西意为？整体东方现代化的建筑，什么东西的整体现代化建筑，不仅表现出欧洲的豪华气派，更应坐落于立池旁，与人什么东西与人？哎，有没有一点震撼啊？我看你们坐在那里都快睡着了，我现在有点难过哎。啊，哇塞，对嘛，发出一点惊叹嘛，有点音效好不好？哎，你。Yes, please.
中文的逗号功能似乎没有那么强。
什么叫没有那么强？什么叫强？
就是说下雨天留人什么？那不是什么？因为逗号的关系才会
影响。Exactly 啊 ，Exactly， 逗号在干嘛？
但是逗，你看，如果我写这段文字的话，我会在整体东方现代化建筑前面加句号，因为我觉得前面是他在描述他的历史，后面是描述他的建筑的风格，对我来说是不同的。
怎么会呢？这个整体东方现代化建筑还是在讲这个玻璃工艺博物馆啊。
我意思是他，我个人写作文我会把它区分开。
你会在这里给一个句点。
对，所以我觉得逗号的功能性没有强，因为我也可以在那边加句号。
好，这是一个很好的 point 啊。意思就是说，哎，其实英文也一样啊。英文你要重新标记 ，punctuation 是very flexible 的，对不对？是你去 define a unit of sentence 嘛。所以我完全 agree 啊，但是这个问题其实英文也一样 ，It's not specific to Chinese. Okay, you can put a comma here if you think this is a topic and this is a different topic. Fine, it's fine. But the thing is, 中文句号代表的是主题单位。You see the point? 那这个 author apparently 当把竹堑玻璃工艺博物馆当作是主题吗？OK， 那你可以觉得说，哎，这个两个其实是不同的主题。Fine, that's fine. But still, the point is， 主题才是我们标记的重点。OK， 主题 才去 define 一个句子。如果把这句话换成英文呢？你们等一下可以试试看哈。主题明确，场景清楚，因此部分内容可以省略，因为我把场景也纳入考量嘛。所以刚刚看的是书面文字 ，OK？ 书面文字，现在来看口语。我今天进来，我就说：“嘿，同学啊，你知道吗？来这里的路上看到一只小鸟，羽毛是蓝色的，很漂亮。但是，一走近就飞了。”我讲的话你懂吗？ Can you understand what I said? 同学们你知道吗？哇，今天真的好奇妙哦。来这里的路上看到一只小鸟，羽毛是蓝色的，很漂亮，但是一走近就飞了。 OK? 当然我是 purposely design 了这个，但是哇，不管我说的是什么你都懂啊。来这里的路上谁来？看到一只小鸟谁看到？羽毛是蓝色的，看到没有？我已经换主词了。谁的羽毛是蓝色的？谁很漂亮？这边是一个经典哈，但是一走近就飞了。谁走近？谁飞了 ？Do you understand what I said? Who approached? Okay, and who flew away? Totally two different subjects, right? But did I say it?Did I mark it? 了解吗？ My marking system, Chinese marking system, does not require I put the subject there. That doesn't mean I can put it. 我当然可以说，但是我一走近，小鸟就飞了。That's fine, okay? If you want to make it clear, that's fine. But you have the choice of dropping them. And most of the time, as you said, simplicity,It's the best. And given that we are lazy people, okay? Whatever you understand, I can choose not to say it. You see my point? So most of the time, we drop a lot of things without even knowing it, without even being aware of it. Okay? Now, this is Chinese. This is the language you speak every day. Do you have a new feeling about it?Okay, try to translate these sentences into English. We talked about Chinese. Now, let's get to English. English is sentence-oriented. What does that mean? 以句子为单位，每个语义成分都在句子的层次上严谨标示。Every semantic element, 每一个语义成分 every semantic element,has to be marked at the level of the sentence. Okay, 这就叫做言句子或是语句导向的语言。So have you read the book? Every element, you read the book, have. 时态。Yes, I have read it. Yes, I did. Okay, 如果你用 did,是用一个 proverb 来回答，但是基本上在句子的单位，在句子的 level, every semantic element has to be clearly marked, overtly marked. 所以回想一下我到底在讲什么，这是一个很重要的观念哈。In Chinese, even though I didn't say it, meaning I didn't mark it overtly,OK, 我没有外显示的来标记。So I ask you, OK, 你读了吗？读了没？我没有 overtly 去 mark subject 跟 object, but is it there? Do I still have that meaning components there? 了解吗？我的语义上面还是有的。I still want to convey the meaning of the subject, the meaning of the object. The only difference is I didn't mark it.In my sentence, there's no overt marking. 懂不懂我在讲什么？所以为什么我们一开始讲语法是一个标记系统？ 因为语义在那边，懂吗？你要讲的那个概念，那个意思 ，the function is there, but the form is different. So there's a different mapping principle between form and meaning. 可以了哈。下一章。What? Yeah, that's a short form. Every language has it. But if you want to have a sentence, and you can't just go yes all the time, right? Yeah, there has to be other things. In your question, okay, that's your answer, but in your question, you have to put all the elements there, okay? So, 什么叫做英语导向的特性？句子和句子之间，句子和句子之间要以清楚的句点作为区隔。所以这叫语句导向。那每一个句子有什么？就是有我们刚刚看到的。回到前一章，一个句子是什么？一个句子就是有一个主词，有一个动词，有一个 object。你说常常句子里面不止一个主词啊 ？OK， but you have to have one main subject, one main verb, one main object。这样了解吗 ？OK， 这就是一个 single sentence unit。下面。OK， 那从刚刚的介绍当中，我们已经看到它基本的个性如此。那我们就要来回答下面的问题：这些规则，我们过去背的铁律哦。老师说，英文里面有 because 就不能有 so。这个规则本身不会空穴来风。OK， it doesn't come from nowhere， right？ It's not out of blue。The rule is there because of what? Because of the fundamental character of English. 了解吗？那为什么不能说 because so? Ending 只能用在疑问句跟否定句吗？现在分词和过去分词。所以我们背过的规则，我这边只是举三个例子，因为这三个例子是最常 bother 我们的。OK? The most botheringrules or questions we had. 重点是 all these rules come from 它的个性 the basic character of English. 可以吗 ?So far, 有没有问题 ?And we'll show that one by one. Okay? So, 从刚刚的接下去从刚刚的 sentence oriented 的这个个性导出来了十大标记系统，这个是它在 marking 上面自然的一种表现，就好像你有一个个性，你的个性是内向的，那你对事情的反应就有 certain OK ways of reacting， 这样懂吗？那这就是基于 the basic personality 你接下来有的这个 ways of reacting， 可以吗？第一个，主动宾不可缺，句子里面的主动宾，我故意用宾语，因为比较押韵，主动宾不可缺，如果主动受不可缺就很奇怪，宾就是宾语，做来宾的受词，可以吗？第二个，重点在前，刚刚我们已经看到了，再来，由小到大，再来，什么叫由小到大？小就是你的重点，你的 focus， 你的焦点，这样懂吗？从 focus 到 background， 这个叫由小到大。第四个，主从分明，谁是主，谁是从，附属的 ，secondary 的，次要的 ，has to be distinctly marked， distinctly marked， OK， 下面，先后有序，谁在前，谁在后是有讲究的。第六个，时间清楚，我的语句表达一个事件，这个事件是什么时候发生的，请标记清楚。接着讲到名词，你要标记清楚这个东西是不是你知我知的。你知我知 ，every time I mention a noun something, I have to mark it whether it's known to you. OK， 下面明辨真假 ，every time I state something, I have to mark it whether it's true or not, whether it's realized.Actualized or not. 下面，厘清责任。Every time I talk about someone, then I have to say, I have to tell you whether this person, this party is responsible for the action. Okay? 所以责任清楚就是主动被动的问题。Every time I have a subject and a verb, I have to specify their relationship. Who is responsible for the action, for the event? 下面，时空转换。This is a general principle across languages. It's not unique to English, but it's used, okay, prevalently in English. So you found this principle, 时空转换. Every time I talk about time, time is abstract. 时间是一个非常抽象的概念，同不同意？什么叫时间？ How do I conceptualize time? I always use spatial concepts to realize, to understand time. 我用空间的概念去理解时间，这个叫时间转，时空转换。想想看，中文也一样哎。中秋节刚什么？说说看，中秋节刚，什么叫过？什么叫过？过的意思是什么？过的核心语义是什么？过，过马路嘛，过桥嘛，过山洞嘛 ，right? You go 什么 across, right? You cross somewhere, 是不是这样子？过的意思就是从空间的那个过啊，越过、跨过的过啊。了解我在讲什么吗？所以“过”这个词的意思，自古到今没有改变，它就是一个空间上面的越过、跨过、穿过、跳过，这样了解吗？那个过，可是这个过的意思呢，被我用在时间上面，表示什么叫中秋节已经过了？了解我的意思吗？这个过的概念是从空间来的，已经越过过去。所以为什么我说过去？你越过的 ，you pass over 的 ，you cross 的地方，是不是已经在后面了？所以不要小看这个时空转换。同样的，在英文里面，所有的介系词，它的核心概念都是从空间来的。以后我们会讲 in 的概念是什么，就是这个空间，三度空间之中，是一个 container 的概念。 OK， 什么叫 in the room？ 有没有想过 in the room 就像 in a box 嘛，一个三度空间的范畴之中的意思。所以从空间的 in 到时间的 in， get your homework done in 10 minutes， 在这个时间的范畴之内你要做完，这样懂吗？所以 in 永远是在范畴之内的意思。 So in 10 minutes， 了解了对不对？所以从 in the room 到 in 10 minutes 到 in love， 现在你懂得什么叫 in love 了吗？什么叫 in love？ Yes， 你沉浸在爱的这个什么范畴之中，永远不要忘记 in 就是个概念。 OK， 所以以前很多人问我说，老师到底我要说 in 台北还是 at 台北？请问你要说 I'm in 台北还是 I'm at 台北？好，第九章我们会讲到介系词哦，现在先小小预告一下。 Should I say I'm in 台北 or I'm at 台北？In Taipei? Can I say I'm at Taipei? Have you ever heard of Taiwan is a self-unknown country? How do we describe our the name of our country? How do we say? Republic of China in Taiwan or at Taiwan?又是一阵沉默。好吧，请问我可不可以说 I'm in Taipei？ 可以的举手。 It's correct， 有人不举手， So I cannot say I'm in Taipei。 是吗？蛤，为什么不可以？你没有举手怎么办？为什么我不可以说 I'm in Taipei？ 可以。那你刚刚在干什么？ OK， 我当然可以说 I'm in Taipei， 因为我把台北当作一个什么一个 boundary 一个范畴来看 ，I'm inside Taipei 的意思，这样懂吗？那我可不可以说 I'm at Taipei？ 可以的，举手。少了很多。好，再问你，你没举手，这次没举手，是不是没举手？我可不可以说 I'm at Taipei？ 你没举手，表示你是不可以嘛，对不对？不清楚。OK， 那以后不清楚的人就举半手好了。Okay? 为什么我可以？Yes, I certainly can say I'm at Taipei, just like I'm at 交大. Okay, where should we meet? Let's meet at 交大. The difference is when you say I'm in Taipei, you mean in. When you say I'm at Taipei, you mean at. 懂了吗？你说老师，你讲的是废话。No, at 就是 at 的意思。什么叫 at？ 只是你要搞清楚 at 的意思。At 意思就是 at a specific spot, at a spot. At 就是在定点的意思。Yes, please.
So, for example, if you say, let's meet at Taipei,
yes.
What's that supposed to mean? Where's the point? For example, if you say, let's meet at Taipei, where I will see you, where I will meet you.
At means at a spot. At a spot. So, at that specific spot. Okay? So, you take Taipei as a spot, a locational spot, then you use at. But you can also say, let's meet in Taipei. So, in...as a boundary. So it's not whether you can say in Taipei or at Taipei. You can say both. You can say either. The point is, what? The point is, what do you want to say? What do you mean? Right? 了解了吗？所以介系词的用法是在这里。当我用 at 的时候 I mean at a specific spot. That's what I want to mean. When I say in Taipei,I'm taking Taipei as a boundary. You see what I mean? Okay? 这十个特色我们一个一个来看。Okay? First one, 主动宾不可缺。你喜欢英语吗？ Everyone, 你们喜欢英语吗？回答我。喜欢。Everyone, see? Okay? Unanimously, 喜欢。That's all.谁喜欢？喜欢什么 ？Do you like English? Yes, I. Can you say like? You see what I mean? No, you can't. You have to say yes, I like it. Yes, I like it. Okay, 那这时候 it 虽然是 unstressed, you don't have to stress it because it's already known. I like it. Okay.But you still have to say it. You still have to mark it. 这叫做主动宾不可缺。有没有问题？所以请你们以后作文的时候注意哈，常常会把你的受词 left out. OK? 下面。试着翻译前面的中文文章。来到这里的路上看到一只小鸟，羽毛是蓝的，很漂亮，但是一走近就飞了。Hey, did you try? On my way here.You have to specify which way, right? I saw, you saw what? A bird. Who saw it? I. 羽毛是蓝色的。Whose 羽毛? It's feather. Okay? 很漂亮。Who looks great? It looks good. 但是一走近, who 走近? As I came near it, 就飞了。谁飞? It flew away.OK, 这就叫做主动宾不可缺。下面。前面的文章呢，新竹 Glass Art Museum was built in 1936. 用分号 fine, but you still have to have a subject. It was used as the local government building under the Japanese ruling. It also served as the residence for the Japanese prince during his visit to Taiwan. It'sModern Oriental Design, 谁的？他的，讲清楚 ，OK? But also due to its location near Mount Beautiful, it gave an impression of elegance and tranquility. It, 不可缺，这样懂了吗？下面，那这边就谈到虚主词的问题啊。我们从小就背虚主词，什么叫虚主词？ 简单的讲，虚主词就是虚位的主词。It occupies the throne， 它站在位置上，但是它没有实权，了解吗？这有点像古代的那个什么，那种皇帝，我们叫什么？背后有一个垂帘听政的，那个皇帝是假的，我们叫什么？傀儡皇帝。Yes， OK。It's raining. It has to be there. But what does it mean? 代替的是天气嘛，它是一个代名词嘛，代替的是天气。It's good that you can. 那个 it 位置在那里。Meaning 呢？我们刚刚说 phone 跟 meaning 的配搭 ，it 有一个 meaning。Meaning 在哪里？在后面，代替后移的子句 that you can is good。那你可以说 that you can is good， 理论上是可以的。Theoretically, it's okay. You can say that you can is good.But 沟通 it's against the normal way of communication. 为什么？一开始你就给一堆新的讯息，一个很重的 heavy information. It's really hard to process. So it's good. What is good that you can? Okay. Be 动词为什么要出现？很多同学对 be 动词完全不了解。我们从小就说 be 动词 be 动词，你知道 be 动词在干嘛？刚刚说主动宾不可少嘛，所以 be 动词就是一个什么动词。那什么时候你要用这个 be 动词？ OK， 你说我打我踢我骂 我都有动词嘛，那什么时候我要用动词 be 动词？什么时候？听着哦，它很高， OK， 我很高，我们大家都很高，这时候为什么要用 be 动词？因为你没有动作嘛，了解吗？你没有动作，而你在形容描述状态的时候， if you are describing a state, a relation, a certain identity, there's no action involved, but you have to have a verb, right? 了解吗？所以 be 动词的定义就是状态连接动词。我的定义很清楚，就是状态。你要描述状态 ，so he's tall. It's a state, right? 了解我在讲什么吗 ？It's not an action. He's hungry. Hungry 是一个状态 ，but you have to have a verb. 我们刚才说主动宾不可少 ，but there's no verb because there's no action. Then you use be. It's a verb to link a subject with a state.So it's called linking verb. 在英文的文法书里面，你看到他们不是叫 be 动词，他们叫 linking verb or copular verb. That's a linguistic term. Okay, a linking verb, linking the subject with a state. 状态或关系的描述也要有动词。Then you have to use this linking verb. He's tall. I'm his teacher. You are the student. 这样了解了吗 ？Okay. 好。这本文法书、啊、是给英文达人的，所以 supposedly 你是 very sophisticated in your English ability. 那我常常会替你问一些问题、哦、I ask questions for you. Do you like English, right? 你说 I like it. You have to say I like it or I don't like it, right? But what about, do you know the answer?Do you know the answer?No, I don't. No. Hey, I don't know. You don't say I don't know it. Right? 你刚不是还说主动宾不可少吗？奇怪，都没有人问我这个问题耶。知不知道我在干嘛？想不想问这个问题？不想问我们就跳过去了。大声一点嘛，OK， 记得你们要有回应啊。好，回到刚刚那页。I don't like it, but you say I don't know. Yes, I know, or I don't know. Most time we say I don't know. Why? 这不是 against 刚刚的 rule 吗 ？So every rule has an exception. Here you have an exception, right?But why do you have this exception? You still have to explain it. Why you can have exception with no, but not with like? 有没有人要试试看回答? Would you like to try? All right. 刚刚这边好像有人要举手。Yes, 谢谢。
Like you said, you have to describe a specific thing,、
mm-hmm.
and know is describing yourself, because you know it, and you don't know. And light is like you like to like what kind of stuff? Not
like describes a specific thing, but know
is describing yourself.
Know is describing yourself. I like, I know.Both are describing me, okay? I like, I know. But I think you are right. There are two different verbs, right? And what is the essential difference in these two verbs?Can you use I don't know this pattern with other verbs? Can you say, I don't, what else?
I don't like.
I don't understand. Can you say, I don't understand? Or I don't understand it. I don't understand it, right? Can you say, I don't have? I don't have it, right? You see what I mean?Okay, well, this is a very interesting question in language, and I want you to recall what I said. 语言是什么？文法是什么？是沟通的产物。语法 the existence of grammar is for communication, right? What do I mean by communication? For use, so you use your language.To achieve communicative goals, right? If there are certain things that we use frequently in our language, frequently, very, very high in frequency, these things tend to be simplified. You use it as a chunk, a fixed chunk.Know, this verb is more frequent. It's more frequently used in the language. It's more common in this language. So you are right. These two verbs seem to be different. Know is a high frequency and a very commonly used verb. As a result, it gets simplified and used as a frozen chunk.所以语言中的确有一些是 ready to use 的这种 chunks, okay? With fixed expression, 就像成语一样。了解我的意思吗？那为什么是 no? 你会发现语言有一个现象，这个是一般学生不会理解的。其实你们的英文老师恐怕也是最近这十年语言学家发现的。Highly frequent words usually gets...Some kind of a expansion. 比方 get 这个动词，它在英文里面的语义多得不得了。如果你去看，有十几种用法。为什么？因为它常常用，常常用是不是就变化比较多？也因为常常用，你就 tend to 简化， you tend to simplify. Okay? Because it gets used so often. 这是语言一个很有意思的现象，语法如此。发音也如此。如果你们不相信 ，If you don't believe me, then try these words. I'll write some words on the board, and you tell me how you pronounce it. Okay, how do you pronounce these words? First one. Every, right? Every. How many syllables? According to the spelling, okay, it should have how many? three syllables. But what did you say? Did you say three clear syllables? Did you say every? No, you say every. You shorten it. You simplified it to two syllables. Next one, family. Family. Again, according to the spelling, it's three syllables. Family. Have you ever say, I have a family? Okay, I have a family. Again, you shorten it. Interesting. Again, you leave out one syllable. Why? You can do it. Try other words. Try all those professional jargon. Okay, 有一些是资工的，有一些是管科的。在你们的教科书当中的那些名词， you can never shorten them. Professional jargons. Okay, you can't do the same. Why? Because of frequency. 常用的词我们就 tend to simplify it. 这样了解吗？ Yes, please.
When you say, I don't get it,、mm-hmm. I don't get it,、mm-hmm. but the while the get is frequent use word,、mm-hmm. but we did not use the same as I don't know.
Yes.
You know, I didn't get.
This is a very good point, okay? When I say get is used frequently, I mean, you can say I get sick, you know, I got him to do something for me, okay? My hair got shaved, okay?You have all these different expressions with get. But get simply doesn't get to the point as no. Because I don't know, I don't know. You use it, this particular sequence, I don't know. You don't say, I don't get, I don't get, I don't get. You don't use it as frequently as I don't know. Okay? Do you know the answer? I don't know.Originally, you have to say, I don't know it. But I don't know, I don't know. Gets to the point that it's frozen there. Do you see my point? So, I can, okay, look. This 不是逻辑上面。你不能说 all frequently used words had to have certain change. You can't say that. But you can explain why certain words get to changed. Okay?You see my point? Why certain words get to this stage? Because they are frequently used. You cannot ask me then, why other frequently used words didn't get to this stage? They will eventually. I don't know. Okay? Maybe one day they will. But all I can tell you is this is used so frequently that it gets frozen.As a fixed chunk. So it's not know as a verb. It's I don't know as one word. Do you get my point? I don't know as one word. Okay? It's not I, verb. You see what I mean? It's I don't know as one word. Okay?
And how about this? For example, do you agree?、Mm-hmm. Do you agree in the sentence there's no object?、Mm-hmm. Do you agree with what? It doesn't say that.
Because you can say I agree that.It does have an in. This is the question related to, what's your name, please? Yeah, her question last time. When you use a verb, you can use it transitively to mean a transitive event. But you can also use it intransitively for your particular purpose of an intransitive meaning. Do you get? So the whole point is the way you mark your sentence, the way you decide.On the form, completely depends on what the meaning you want to say. Okay? So what is the meaning? What do you want to say? What do you mean? Decides what you use in your sentence. Meaning determines the form.Meaning determines the structure. Okay? Function determines the form. So, it always, ask yourself, what do I really want to say? Then you use the appropriate form to convey that meaning. Do you get my point? Okay, thank you. 下面，重点在前，第二点。In a sentence, you have different elements, okay? 头是重点，辅是修饰。中文，先看中文。Let's look at Chinese first. 中文，如果你有一个名词你要修饰的时候，谁前谁后？ You say, 努力的人。What's the head of this phrase? 人。You're talking about 人，了解吗？小心的走。What's the head? 走， the verb. It's a VP, so it's a verb. 我昨天买的那本书 ，OK， 那本书是 head， and where do you put the head in the phrase？ 中文所有的重点都在后。我比小明高，我比小明，你说出来了没有？你说我比小明哦，我比小华哦，我比小虫哦 ，OK， 我比小胖哦。你都没有讲出来重点，一直到最后，我比小明高，这样了解哈。同样的 event， 昨天晚上七点钟，我到他们家吃饭。上个星期六下午三点钟，我看见小明。了解我在讲什么吗？重点在后。同样的，为什么我们刚刚有那样的一个问题？为了省钱，他坐公车。你不会说他坐公车，不是不会说啦，很少。OK， 他坐公车为了省钱，所以中文的重点倾向在后面。Again， tend to 放在后面，这个叫做 head final。Head final。相对于中文呢，英文重点在前。注意哈。如果一个语言的个性如此，在语言的每一个层次，你都会看到 consistent。You will see the character consistently， 这样了解吗？所以名词片语如此，动词片语如此，子句如此 ，consistent for NPs, for VPs, for clause, for sentences, same thing, and even for a paragraph, for an essay， 同不同意？英文的重点在前 ，a person who works hard， 名词 ；walk carefully， 动词 ；the book I bought yesterday， 关系子句 ；I'm taller， comparatives， 你还是要说重点先 ，I'm taller， this is the main point， and then you say then who， okay？ I ate dinner， that's the main event， at 7 last night。He took the bus to save money. This is head initial. 这样了解吗？重点在前。Yes, please. Yeah, sure. 这个叫做 attributive. Okay. 所有的 attributive, 英文也有啊。你也可以说a hardworking person. Or you can say a person who works hard. Okay, so...Attributive adjectives can always be pronominal. Okay? 每一个语言都一样的。But if you use, predicative adjectives, then it's different. Okay? 所以一个很漂亮的女人 a beautiful woman, 一个很漂亮的女人。So 英文有所谓的 attributive adjectives 跟 predicative adjectives.It's like, I am tall versus a tall person. Okay? So attributive adjectives is a different, it's a different pattern. Okay? 但是除了 attributive adjectives, 其他的 NP, VP sentence, you all see this consistent character. 重点在前。Again, 我说这是一个 tendency, okay? 好， 句子如此，片语如此。Head initial for phrases, head initial for sentences. What about a paragraph? What about an essay? 后面有吗？ Not yet. What about an essay? Hey, 你们有没有上过英文作文？英文作文，老师通常第一课都会谈到什么？ When you start an essay, you have to have a topic sentence. And in the first paragraph, you have to state your narrow focus with a thesis statement. Remember? 是这样子。So the first paragraph is an introductory paragraph. Everything is already there. 你的重点讲清楚，放在前面。一样的。So consistently, you see head initial. Way of thinking, way of writing, way of speaking. 不要小看这件事情啊。你知道，你下次你们注意看那个电视的访谈啊。美国人讲话也是一样的。This is the way they speak. They give you the main point first.Oh, I like it very much. And then they explain why. Okay? Oh, this is lousy. So you give a general statement, stating your main point first. And then you give supporting details. Is that the essay writing format? 是不是这样子? Essay 也是一样。You tell the main point in your first paragraph, and then you have supporting details.In the following paragraph, and then you make a conclusion. So general to specific, same thing. Next one. 英文由小到大，由焦点慢慢扩大至全景，是 zoom out 的。So from your focal point, your focus, then to the whole background. 有没有？这个跟重点在前也类似，是相关的。中文呢？先看后面的全景，再慢慢缩小至焦点。所以昨天晚上下，昨天晚上八点钟 ，OK， 我在看电视的时候，你们看到你的background交代清楚了，最后才讲出重点。小明打电话来，同样的，你有没有发现写地址也是这样子？你有没有问过为什么中英文写地址的方式不一样 ？This is the reason。台湾。台北市新生南路三段二十二巷一百号，请问重点是什么？一百号才是你真正的 residency 吗？了解吗？一百号才是那个最 narrow 的 focus， 放在最后。英文呢 ？Number 100， 了解吗？由小到大，跟刚刚的重点先讲是息息相关的。下面篇章的结构也一样。中文是从 background 慢慢的，所以你看每次我要讲什么，我们就先寒暄两句，对不对？哎，你妈妈好吗？你爸爸好吗？你儿子好吗？你们家小狗好吗？然后最后才说可不可以借我200块？了解我在讲什么吗？是不是这样子？不要笑哦，这就是中文。所以他们说中国人常常 beat around the bush and we are indirect. You see why? It's the way you talk. Okay? You are indirect because.You don't say it directly, but 英文呢 ？Topic sentence, thesis statement, directly. You state your main point directly at the beginning. So topic plus thesis statement already tells you everything, and then you support your main idea with supporting details, and then you make a conclusion. So general to specific to general.OK， 不要小看这个。我今天不教你们文 writing， 我下一本书可能想要写英文作文有诀窍。OK， 就是这个诀窍，请你们拭目以待吧。OK， 下面第四点，主从分明。英文严谨的讲究句子间的主从关系。我们刚刚已经讲过，重点只能有一个。OK， 一个句子只能有一个重点，重点要先讲。一个句子只能有一个主要子句，那一个主要子句里面只能有一个主要主词，一个主要动词。不要小看这个哦，这就是所有英文句子最重要的一点。所以常常你看你们最常犯的问题是什么？一个句子里面有两个动词，对不对？是不是这样？你是不是常搞这种飞机哈 ？Main clause 只能有一个，其他的都是 subordinate。这就是上次我也其实已经讲了。 Because, so, 为什么不可以放在一起合用 ？OK， 两个都变成 subordinate。下面，所以英文不能说 because, so， 因为同时有 because, so， 两句都加了附属标记，都成了从没有主，违反主从分明的原则。你觉得这个很难吗？为什么我们在高中学 because, so， 国中吧 ？OK， can our teacher explain this to us? Do you think you would be able to get it?Even though you are in middle school. 可不可以？嘿，回答我了。你觉得国中的时候老师如果告诉你，英文是一个主从分明的句子，所以你不能说 because so. 你可以 could you get it? Yeah, I don't think this is so difficult to understand. But how come they didn't tell us? Because their teachers didn't teach them. Okay? 所以若有两个子句，一定是一组、一从、一正、一负，要有一个陈述重点的主要子句。很多老师其实有 somehow 也了解这一点，可是还要再进一步讲一个重点，就是你的主从之间怎么决定，谁要作为主要子句，谁要作为附属子句。 How do you decide? Which one is the main clause?我在改作文的时候才发现，原来这个也是一个问题。When I grade students' writings, I realize this is a problem too. Okay, I know there has to be a main clause, there has to be other things are subordinate. But usually you find things. If I say, I bought the book because it's fun to read, what is my main point? How do you know?Okay, again, there's form and meaning, right? The form I use, I bought the book because it's fun to read. In terms of form, this is my main clause. And my main clause has to have the main point. So you use your main clause to convey the main point. 不要小看这件事情啊。作文的时候你们常常就是把重点放在 although 里面。OK? 了解我在讲，所以形意要彼此相符。You have to have the exact mapping between form and meaning, the appropriate mapping. 下面。何谓主要子句？ What is a main clause? Main clause is an independent clause, 独立子句。什么叫独立？我一个人就活得很好，我不需要依靠谁。Okay, I don't rely on anyone. I can be independently, 怎么样 exist as a sentence. So, 独立子句予以完整，可独立成句。I'm interested in English. Okay, the sentence by itself is a complete thought. 附属子句予以不完整，无法独立成句。If I say, if you are interested in English, you see what I mean?语义完整了吗？讲完了没？没讲完嘛。语义独立了吗？不独立嘛。You see? 所以所有的语法是从语义出发的。这样了解吗？你要沟通的，沟通清楚没？没有啊。If you are interested in English, 你就还没讲完嘛。啊，你还没讲完，为什么不继续把它讲完？这样了解了吗？ So this is a subordinate clause. 好。那谁是主要动词？这也是一个问题啊。你知道要有一个主要动词，我们刚刚说一主一副，一个句子里面只能有一个主要动词。那我有一堆动词的时候怎么办？主要动词的 definition 就是只有一个动词带有时间标记。There can only be one tensed verb. Main verb means the tensed verb.The tensed verb. 懂不懂什么意思 ?Tensed. 就是 with tense marking. 你看看这个是不是所有句子，回去不信的话分析所有的英文句子。There's only one tensed verb. 其他的呢，你要不然就用 to, infinitival, 要不然你就用 ing, 要不然你用 that clause. That clause 就是另外一个子句了嘛。那这些都没有 tense. To 没有 tense, ing 也没有 tense. It doesn't tell you when.过去、现在还是未来，这样了解吗？所以主要子句就是 tensed verb。那回到你们的作文， 一个句子里面不可以有两个 tensed verb without a conjunction. 你说我可不可以说 well, he went and danced. I have two tensed verbs. 可不可以？当然可以。那你是有一个对等的连接嘛？了解好，你用连接词当然可以，可是 without 连接词一个子句里面只有一个动词是有时间标记的，那请问，哎，我每次都喜欢问哈，为什么？为什么只有主要子句有 tense? Why the main verb is the tensed verb? What is the tensed verb? What does it do in a sentence?我刚刚给你一个定义，对不对？你接受了？你接不接受？你不能够就是随便接受嘛，你只要问一下为什么嘛 ，right？ 为什么主要子句是 tensed verb？ 有没有想过？为什么不是 to 或 ing 没有 tensed verb？因为要讲清楚、right? 我觉得这个同学回答得很好嘛，讲清楚什么，你看其实答案都在沟通里面嘛，为什么加 tense， 你加 tense 讲清楚了什么，
就是它是主要动词，所以你要讲清楚它的重点要讲什么，就
那加了 tense 我讲清楚了什么，
时间
yeah exactly， 如果我是主要来描述这个时间， if I amused to describe the main event, then do I have the responsibility to tell you when it happened? 了解吗？既然我的功能是要描述主要的事件，那我当然要在我这个动词上面讲清楚时间咯。I have to convey the time too. If I am the main character, I have to perform all the functions for describing this main event. OK, 下面。句子自然的顺序是重点在前，背景在后，所以 主先从后就不用额外再加标点符号。不要小看这个、啊、以前老师们有没有教你们说哦，如果 because, when, if 在前面的话你就要有 comma， 如果在后面就不用。 So fasten your seatbelt to avoid， 要不要加逗号？如果你放在前面呢， to avoid death or injury， 要不要 comma？为什么？了解吗？为什么？有没有问过？为什么附属子句在前面的时候要加 comma？ 很简单啊，因为它符合了先主后从，主先从后，这样了解吗？我符合重点在前的原则，这是不是我自然的顺序？我就不需要加 comma， 所以标点符号是 meaningful 的，标点符号也是一种语法，你们同意吗？Punctuation has grammatical meaning. Okay? Punctuation has grammatical meaning. 听懂这句话了吗？我加逗号的意思是什么？ If I say, to avoid death and injury, comma, what does that comma do there? 刚刚才说 punctuation has grammatical meaning, so what does it convey to you? What is the grammatical function of the comma there?他在干嘛？ Yeah, separate 是一个原因啦，可是那我后面为什么就不用 separate？ If I use comma, that means what? 你有想过我用 comma 告诉你的是什么？ Exactly. Comma 前面的 is not the main point yet. You should look for the main point after the comma.If it's the main point, if the main point has already been expressed, then you use what? Period. So comma is like a reminder. Prompt you. Okay? To expect the main point. So comma means it's not the main point yet. It's not the main point yet. It's not the main point yet. Here's the main point. And then period. 了解了吗？不要小看 punctuation, 哈。So after he left his office...John went to the party. anything before a comma is not the main point. 可以了吗？下面。先后有序，标点符号具有语法的含义。哦哦，那个错了哈。那从在前，主在后，就要加标点警示，就是我刚刚讲的哈。那另外一个我要强调的是，主从要形意相符。形式上的主要子句就必须是语义上的主要事件。所以如果今天我要讲的是 I went to the party last night, 这是我主要要讲的。Hey, you know what? I went to the party last night, 这是我的主要重点，语义上的主要重点。我在形式上就要怎么样把它放在主要子句。I went to the party last night, although it rained heavily. 但是常常我在作文里面会看到这种句子。你明明要讲的是 I went to the party as the main point. You say, although I went to the party last night, it rained heavily. 这叫形意不符 mismatch. There's a mismatch between form and meaning. Because what you truly want to say is I went to the party last night, then mark it as the main clause. 可以了吗？ Do you get it? Am I clear? Good.